I've taken up the topic of podcast, but what is podcast? The word podcasting is a fusion of broadcasting and iPod. One might think or loosely define it as something like a radio, but it's actually quite different from that. Podcast can be defined as a progression of audio episodes regularly surrounded around a specific topic or point. One can subscribe the show with an application on their phone and tune into episodes whenever and wherever they desire. And this is exactly where it draws itself different from a radio. Unlike radios, one doesn't have to switch channels to get them something interesting. Instead, they can download something exactly of their interest and enjoy it. But what are podcasts really like? This question would be in anyone's mind who's listening to this word for the first time. So let me take you through this doubt with the help of an example. Whenever you want to start watching a new web series, what do? Select in the genre, have a look at all the options, and then select one with the most appealing description and start watching it, right? Similarly, a specific podcast will be themed around a specific point about which they talk each week. There are a variety of podcasts available in every genre, touching down a range of topics, and can be broadly categorized as the following on the basis of their format. Mercier defines micro-celebrity as the commitment to deploying and maintaining one's online identity as if they were a branded good, with expectations that others do the same. To name a few micro-celebrities in the field of podcast would be Tamar Avishai, who is known for his interviews with unsuspecting museum visitors. That podcast is called A Piece of Work. Left, Right and Center, hosted by Matthew Miller and Robert Skier, a member of the Center for American Progress, where they take up political debates. There are many podcasts that are run by celebrities like Dax, Armchair Expert, and one big reason behind this is to attract audience. As Glory rightly quotes, celebrity hosts gather an audience whose primary goal is to take personal contact with them, achieving access to the world of media people, and thus leaving the ordinary behind. Each of these podcast celebrities have used internet as not just a commodity, but as a marketplace to reach their customers. The internet contributes to a dynamic by which users frame themselves simultaneously as sellers, buyers, and commodities. This form of media has given major exposure and power to normal people like you and I. As Gilmore calls, we the media and the former audience. That is, now we the audience who decide what is important and not just few people in power. Anyone today can start a podcast and even give their opinions in the form of reviews, without having any formal qualification and status in the media industry. Today, consumers are the kings. Podcasts do not only give us a great variety of content, but also make entertainment highly economical, as one can download a majority of podcasts for free and can enjoy it on the go. Apart from being economical, they have served a crucial role in promoting community health. 45 podcasts focused on topics selected from a community health needs assessment with input from health researchers. Episodes lasted about 22 minutes and presented health-related projects, community events, and community resources, with most featured guests from Olmsted's country. They raised high awareness among the general community, thereby promoting welfare. Podcasts have grown in popularity with time, According to ABC, 62% of Australians have ever listened to a podcast. Figure is up from 29% last year. Hence, I would conclude by quoting Gerald Mohn. Broadcast radio is the cockroach of media. You can't kill it. You can't make it go away. It just gets stronger and more resilient.